16th conference of CITU is going on since yesterday. It has started yesterday, 23rd of January, and it is a 5-day conference. It will go up to 27th of January. And since yesterday, we had an inaugural session where the central trade unions, who are part of the joint central platform of trade unions, including representatives, leaders of INTUC, AITUC, HMS, AIUTUC, AICCTU, etc. LPF also, they all came and greeted the conference. And the president of WFTU, the World Federation of Trade Unions, he is also here. He greeted the conference yesterday, and today also he intervened and gave his message. And yesterday the conference in the inaugural session itself has adopted three very important resolutions. One is against the demanding the repeal of the Citizenship Amendment Act, and also to stop the process of NPR, People's Population Register. So we have decided, we called upon the conference, called upon all its cadres to not answer the NPR questions. Because you know, the NPR and census, both will be conducted at the same time. The same enumerator will come. So we have decided that the census answers we will give, but the NPR related answers will not give. Because on that basis, doubtful citizens, they will mark, the enumerators will mark D. And those doubtful citizens, they have to prove that they are citizens. It is not the government which has to prove, but they have to prove. And in our country, large number of workers, particularly in the unorganized sector, it is not a issue of Muslims or Hindus, etc. It is not a religion base. That is there in the CAA. But the main thing is that large number of workers who are illiterate and in the unorganized sector, they won't have the required certificates. So if anybody is marked as a doubtful citizen, to have, they don't know even their own date of birth, they know place of birth, then their father's name of place of birth, etc. It will be very difficult, almost impossible. So that will be utilized to harass the workers and deny them the citizenship, so which is a basic right of the people of this country. So on that, we have decided that NPR process should be blocked at any cost. So that resolution has been adopted. Similarly, on J&K also, the abrogation of Article 370 and the blockade of internet, the government is saying that they have started internet, etc. But we have delegates from Jammu and Kashmir who have told that even today, internet is not available for most of the citizens and they are not free to move, etc. It's a very difficult situation for them. So we have adopted that has to be taken back and restored. And all those who have been arrested, they should be released. That is our demand. And similarly, you might be knowing, in France, the rail and road transport workers, they are on strike since the 5th December last year. And the main demand is against pension reforms. Like in our country, the government has introduced NPS. The government employees, central government, state government, railway defense, etc. The old pension system, that is, there is no guaranteed pension, but there is guaranteed contribution. So that new pension system we are opposing. Similarly, in France also, the government has taken up pension reforms. There are 42 different types of pensions there. They want to amalgamate all those. And as per the new, what the government wants to do, Macron's government, that the workers will have to work for longer years and they will get less pension, lower pension. So they apprehend that they will have to, now it is 62 years, retirement age is 62 years. Now it will be increased to 64 years. So to get a pension, the workers have to increase up to 60, they have to work up to 64 years. So they are on strike. The people of France are supporting the strike. So we also have supported the French workers' strike. We have adopted another important resolution on violence against women. Every year we observe International Women's Day, and probably you know International Women's Day was started as Working Women's Day, where the working women are on the streets demanding right to vote, maternity benefits, equal wages, etc. So this year, even after 70 years in our country, women don't get these benefits, equal wages, etc. The government has merged, Equal Remuneration Act also is one of the acts that were merged in the Code on Wages Bill. Code on Wages Act it has become now. There the government talks about equal wages, but even today equal wages are not available to most of the women workers. In addition to that, violence against women is going on. You see, whether it is the mass gang rape and killing in 2016, Nirbhaya, what we call Nirbhaya case in 2016 in Delhi, now the Disha case in Hyderabad. And similarly, not only these, everywhere, almost all the states it is taking place, children are being raped, children are being killed, etc. It has become most brutal and bestial type of rapes and killings are going on. So against that, we have decided that against violence of women, on 8th March, the women will court arrest. We are the CITU, those women who are members of the CITU, they will court arrest all over the country, demanding safety and implementation of the labor laws, etc., and also the women specific laws, effective implementation of those laws. And we also have appealed to the other women's organizations and also the women working in the other trade unions or other sectors of society to come together and court arrest, highlighting the specific problems of women. In addition to that, yesterday there was the presidential address and the general secretary report was presented, the preliminary one report was presented. So that the presidential address that has outlined the situation across the world, international, what is happening in different, because what we find today is that similar conditions like in our country, they are found all over the globe in many places. One, the neoliberal policies, they are attacking the rights of the workers, particularly after the 2008 crisis. The crisis has not abated. Even now it is continuing. The latest report of the IMF also is saying that it has not yet bottomed out. And the IMF chief says that the economic situation in the world is uncertain. So because it is uncertain, investments, there is no guarantee. The rights of the workers are under attack. That is one challenge. And on the other side, the right-wing forces in several places are gaining. And the imperialism and the international finance, they are also promoting and encouraging the right-wing forces because they don't have any alternative to the neoliberal policies. They don't have any pro-worker or pro-people policies. When they are in government, they are implementing the same policies. So they are like in US you see Trump, or in other places also, in Brazil you see Bolsonaro, in our own country you see Modi. So these forces are being encouraged. So this is not going to address the problems of the working class, whether it is unemployment or the labor rights, the basic rights of the workers, the social security, pension or wages, etc. So what we want is these policies have to be defeated. And such struggles are going on across the world in many places, not only in France, in many other places also. In the USA also, workers are out on the streets, in Canada, in many other places. For the first time, young workers are coming onto struggles, women workers are coming into struggles. Some sectors where till now they have not participated in any struggle, those sections are also coming into struggles. So on the one hand, these challenges are there. On the other, we find that the workers are resisting. Such is the situation in our country also. So from this, what we understand is that if the workers come together, along with the other sections of the toiling people, like the peasants, agricultural workers also, then these struggles can be intensified and these struggles can be taken to a higher level so that these policies will be defeated. So with that understanding, the presidential address and the general secretary's report also were presented and discussions are going on these two. As of now, from several states, delegates have spoken. And today, the discussion on this part one of the general secretary's report will be over. In the evening, the General Secretary will introduce another part which will deal mainly with the organization, and tomorrow that will take place. And from this conference on 26th, we have decided, on 23rd it was Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose's birthday. So we have garlanded his, to start with, his portrait, and took a pledge that we will carry forward, because his ideals, his principles and what he stood for, those principles are under attack today with the BJP government. So we took a pledge that we will carry forward his ideals. 26th is where our Republic Day, where the constitution has come into practice. So on that day, we will form a human chain. We'll outside the venue, we'll form, all the delegates will hoist the flag, the national flag, and then they will stand in a human chain and take a pledge of CIT, also saying that we'll try to carry forward, we'll protect the constitution, the tenets of the constitution, the spirit of the constitution, and then what the CIT is constitutional objective also, we will march forward to achieve that. And then on 27th there will be a mass rally. So basically this is this, and we have also decided to participate the 30th January, which is Mahatma Gandhi's Martyrdom Day. On that also the CIT members and committees will organize demonstrations on that day.